pretty much rolled in packs of 10. One radio with 10 guys, and they would just circle the whole place and, you know, try to keep peace where they could.
You have to learn to be on their good side.
Certain niggas used to run down on you, they see you smoking, they try to tell you, yo, give me $20 or some shit like that. But you give them that shit and get the fuck out of here. You smoking all night.
I mean, that was our hustle. We used to tax dudes, yo, you smoking, you wanna smoke weed in that corner, you know, you gotta pay for that.
It was a lot of security in there that overdid their job sometime, but overall, it was cool.
Soon as a fight broke out, you might get 2-3 hits. They were coming in a line. And if you wasn't looking when that line came, it was gonna run you over.
They beat you up first, and then they ask questions later.
They would just hem people up, have you out the door.
They'll lift you straight the fuck up.
They wouldn't throw you out, they'd bounce you out.
They love knocking niggas out, yo. They loved it.
You know, we had to put our paws on niggas. That was part of the game.
If one got into a fight, you better believe you was getting your ass whipped by that whole side of the tunnel.
That was a place where you come and you know you couldn't act up, because you act up, you going out one way or another.
I seen dudes 7 foot tall, 500 pounds, go to my boss, talk about, yo, you can keep that bread for the night. I can't have no parts of this. I'm out of here, because they were soft like that.
Nowadays, you can take a test, and anybody can get certified. You couldn't get certified in that building taking that type of test. So only one test you had to pass up in that building. Certification, hands on.
It could be a fight amongst 20 people. Security's gonna get in that fight.
You just see giants coming everywhere, every angle. And some of them motherfuckers had guns.
The leader of the pack behind Sterling, because he was the head security, he would have a 4-pound out.
And then on the way out, they gonna rough you up and break you up and rob you and take your chain and your money and your ID and then toss you off these 4 steps.
They was quick fast to catch you fighting or drunk. Once you drunk, that was straight payday. When they throw you out, your wallet gone, everything gone. Your motherfucking coat gone. Be wintertime, nigga, you freezing, fucked up, drunk. They took my coat. They talking about, what you talking about? You had your shit.
Absolutely. And if you make, and you know what's crazy about tunnel security now? If you see them same dudes and interviewed them, they would tell you that they used to rob niggas back in the day.
100%.
100%. Were people getting robbed at the tunnel by security? Allegedly.
Well, you know, I plead the fifth. You know what I mean? I ain't gonna say, but you know, you know what I mean? I honestly, man, the security was some good dudes, man. If a nigga said he got robbed, he was doing wrong.
You got in a problem in the tunnel, your fucking arms got stretched like this, nigga put you in the yoke, and they went in your pockets.